Welcome to New Life Christian Fellowship Church in Gaston, Oregon. We now join Pastor Dwayne with today's message.
Again, we welcome you. Everyone is here today. You know, this is the beginning of a new year. And last week, I laid out a number of things that, goals, I guess you would call them, direction that we're going to go. Physically and spiritually, I already mentioned one of them was new windows in the building. I expect that this whole project will be done by Easter.
Hi, Tim.
Hi, Joy. Yeah, just kind of waving at some of these guys that I know, man, they really know how to do it, you know. My son-in-law here, Jerry, he's good at that, too. So we're going to round up a crew. And 29 windows, $200 a piece. That's kind of an average. And the Lord's going to do it. I would love to be able to say, we'll write a check for that. But we're not backed by an organization. We're backed by God.
Amen.
And for me to do that, for us to do that, would take all the blessing away from you. I want you to be blessed. Praise God. I brought in scripture of Isaiah. It won't be up on the screen just yet. I don't want that up there just now. But it was in Isaiah 54. And as I looked at this, I realized that in 1976, the beginning of the year, 1976, the Lord gave me this promise. And I'm claiming this promise this year. This is the year for it. Enlarge your house. Build an addition. Spread out your home. Spare no expense. For you will soon be bursting at the seams. Your descendants will occupy other nations and resettle the ruined cities. Verse 4. Fear not. You will no longer live in shame. Don't be afraid. There's no more disgrace for you. You'll no longer remember the shame of your youth and the sorrows of widowhood. I believe it's time to expand greater than we have before. Moving into this building was an expansion.
Amen.
All right. You know, Jim, I was thinking the other day of that building that's now an apartment down there. When we moved into that, we really thought we were moving uptown.
Amen.
Remember that? And then when you raise your hands, you touch the ceiling. I mean, you couldn't ask for a raised hand, Harley, because you'd be touching the ceiling, you know? But it's not a problem here. You don't touch the ceiling here. It's time for growth. I want to begin today in Philippians chapter 3. Verse 12 through 16. They're going to throw it up on the screen there for us. And we're going to start there. Praise God. Philippians chapter 3, beginning at verse 12. You see it up there? You can follow. And I'm going to read it, the Living Bible here. He says, this is Paul writing. He said, I don't mean to say that I've already achieved these things or that I've already reached perfection, but I press on to possess that perfection for which Christ Jesus first possessed me. Verse 13. No, dear brothers, I have not achieved it, but I focus on this one thing, forgetting the past and looking forward to what lies ahead. Let's talk about it. Right here is step number one to moving forward in God. If all you want to do is talk about history, you'll never move forward. And if you're locked up with just history and the past,
oh, this is how it used to be, or this is what it used to act like, or this is the way the people used to do it. If you're locked up in that, you'll never move forward. It will blind you. But if you will step out with faith and say, I believe the world belongs to me. I believe God's got a future for me, second to none. If you're happy just over here in your little corner, us four and no more, then you'll never move forward. I am saying to you, God wants his people to move forward, to believe him for great things, outstanding things, unbelievable things, things like you've never seen before. That's why I've said, God told me, spoke to me through his spirit and said, this will be a healing station. We sang about it today. There are going to be people coming here that are sick and need healing, and we're going to pray for them, and they're going to leave healed. Say, I don't believe in it. Don't bother me. Because I've got, I believe it. Yeah. And the Bible says it. And that's good enough. Hello? Yeah. Moving forward. You got to forget the past. You say, but I tried it before. You know, Satan is good at reminding you of all your failures. And he's good at reminding you all the bad stuff you used to do. Well, I know some of you real close. And you've told me some of your secrets. But you know what? That's over with. You've got a bright future, man.
Amen. Praise God.
Yeah. You got a bright future. Things are exciting. Look at the physical alone. Just look at the physical things around us. It won't be long till all the students of this facility, of this community, will be going to a brand new facility. Amen. Now, a year ago, everybody thought, never happened. Gaston don't pass bonds. We're locked up in the old line, man, you know. But God had some people that knew how to pray. And had vision and begin to believe and look forward. And God's doing some outstanding stuff in the church world. In the church world. I'm telling you, I'm excited about our nation. I'm excited about our community. I'm excited about this church. I'm excited about other churches in this community. God's doing some wonderful, wonderful things. I remember when Wapato began to talk about buying that building down there. I remember they went to the city council, and I was there, and I said, you know what? I think it's a great idea that they buy that. And they did. And they're refurbishing it. And there will be a center for people to go to, young people, older people, whatever. That's vision, man. That's not focusing on this is my helper boy. I love this kid right here, man. He helps me a lot, right? Yeah. Yeah, he said, you got to forget the past. Satan is a liar. He's like a little fox, and he'll lie to you in the secret of your in your secrets of your mind. He'll come to you and harass you, and he'll try to bring up your past to you. I'm going to tell you something. The Bible said, I forget the past. I forget what I used to do. I forget the things. I forget those habit patterns. They're under the blood. Are they going to creep up sometime? Yeah, they're going to creep up. You betcha. But God can help you overcome them. Hello. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's keep reading here. He says, I look forward, forgetting the past, I look forward to what lies ahead. Now, I don't know everything that lies ahead. It's an unknown. But I believe that the same God that brought me here can take me there.
Amen.
Amen.
I believe in the empty
yeah.
grave.
Because it's faith. And you know, I believe in the book. You know, Amen. I was telling somebody the other day, my Susan and I were talking about this. I said, I really believe that God's going to give me a long life.
Amen. Amen. We've been praying for that, Pastor.
Thank you. And I'm going to tell you why. Young people, perk up. Turn your hearing aids up, like mine. I have always, my entire life, honored my mother and father. And you know what the Bible says? You honor them and you got a long life.
Amen.
I can never, Steve, remember saying anything like this. My old man, my dad, first of all, if I was close to him, he would help me not to say it again. Yeah, it'd be, you know, it was back in the days when you did things like that, you know, just whoop, you know. That's what the Bible says. Honor. And he's promised you things. Praise God. So there's a lot of the unknown that I don't know, but I'm going to walk there and I'm going to do it by faith because he's going to be with me. He's going to direct me. He's going to lead me every step of the way. Let's look at some more of this verse. We want to keep it. Verse 14. Press on, I press on to reach the end of the race and receive the heavenly prize for which God through Christ Jesus is calling me. Press on in the race. Press on. Now listen, if you're running the race in things of God, there's going to be some problems. The first problem you're going to come across is discouragement. How are you feeling today? Man, I'm so discouraged. I don't know what I'm going to do. Why are you so discouraged? Well, I prayed and it didn't happen last week. I'm glad that Jesus taught us, he said, remember the parable he said, you keep knocking at the door? You ever gone to someone's house and you know they're in there? Come on now. And you knock at the door, and if you don't want to see them, you just dismiss yourself. Well, they must not be home. But if you really want to see them, hello. And if it's one of your kids wanting to come get some money from you, hello. They're going to keep... Of course, you never did that.
No.
No. Better be careful, David. Dad's right up there, man. Yeah. Discouragement. If you're going to press on in this race, you're going to be handle discouragement. And then you're going to get tired. You know, you say, well, I'm so tired this morning. I got to sleep in. You ever felt that way? Yeah. Did he make you get out of bed?
Yeah.
That's what I thought. You see, I saw him yesterday. He said, I'll see you tomorrow. So he had a promise he had to keep. So he had to get you up to come. Thank you. Man, I'm glad you did that for me, man. You're going to get tired. There's nowhere in God's Word that says, you'll never be exhausted, you'll never be tired, just keep going, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. If you're running this race and you're pressing on to great things, you're going to get tired. And you know who you're going to have to deal with too? Those wonderful, encouraging, I say that kind of quietly, people that come along. Hello. You ever had people give you a bad time? Yeah. Yeah. Don't you like to be around positive people? But I'm going to tell you, if you're going to run this race, you're going to meet up with some negative people.
That's true.
Isn't that right? Yeah. He's been trying to talk to his dad, and his dad, he's got other stuff on his mind right now. But you know what? You keep doing it. You keep doing it. And you keep doing it. You keep knocking. You keep running. Praise God. Galatians 5:7 said, you did run well. You were doing a good job. Why did you allow people to trip you up? Why did you allow people to get in your way? Because I'm telling you something, everybody is not going to encourage you. If we were passing out $100 bills here this morning, somebody wouldn't like it because they'd want more. Hello. Come on now. You know, so you're going to have people that are going to come to you and they're going to, in fact, here's the worst part. Here's the worst part. And especially if you're running in the race and you're out in front and you're kind of breaking ground, you're going to have criticism. Yeah.
Don't be looking at my duck shirt.
I didn't say anything about your duck shirt. This guy works on cars. And I'm sure that every now and then he gets a customer said, "You didn't do that just exactly right." I walked into a store here last week to get a battery for a car, and I said, so I was thinking all the way over there, what am I going to say to this guy, kind of, you know, soften him up a little bit. So I walked over to the counter and I said, "What do you have for old people?" I said some other stuff that I shouldn't be saying, probably. "And that are broke and don't have any money." I said, "Do you hear that very often?" He started smiling. He said, "Every day." I said, "I knew that." I said, "I had to think of something to say to you. What I'm telling you, if you're going to run, you did run, keep running." Paul said, "I'm reaching. I'm running. I got a prize out there." What is that prize? What is that heavenly prize? I don't know what it is. I have no idea. Because it's not heaven. That's a foregone conclusion. If you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and you've accepted him, there's only one other place for you to go when you die, and that's to heaven. So that's not a prize, man. There's some other things in between there that he said, "I'm reaching for." Maybe it's to reach more people. Maybe it's to touch more lives. I don't know what it was, but he said, "I reach toward that heavenly prize for which God, through Christ Jesus, is calling me." So Jesus was saying to him, the Holy Spirit was saying to him, "I've got something for you out there." In my interpretation of that, it's greater things in God. He's going to use us more. We'll be stronger in our walk with him. Let's keep reading. Verse 15. "Let all who are spiritually mature agree on these things." Ooh, Lordy. I thought, spiritually mature. I've met some people that claim they're mature, but man, their definition of maturity in spiritual things is different than mine.
Amen.
But who am I to judge, eh?
True.
But I'm going to tell you this. The Bible says, by their fruit, you'll know them. You don't have to say, "I'm spiritually mature," or "I'm a giant in the Lord." Your life will speak it. Amen. You don't have to have a sign saying, "Well, guess what? I'm a believer." Hallelujah. You walk it and people will know it. They'll ask you, "What's different about you, man? What's taking place?" See, I've never seen this like that. How do you know? Fruits and actions. Attitude. Faithfulness. Cooperation. Submission. Man, oh man, oh man. I thought back so many times. I thought, "Lord, how much more can I submit to you? How much more can I submit to the pastors that I submit to, Lord? How much more can I be what you want me to be without complaining?" Now, some people will submit, but boy, I'm telling you what, you could see where they went because they left a plow, a furrow in the ground where they had their heels dug in, submitting. Faithfulness, cooperation. I learned something a long time ago. I may not always agree, but he's going to deal with me so that I can be more submissive, more submission to him. Let's look at verse 16. He said, "But we must hold on to the progress we've already made." So, as we run in the race, and as we're believing for greater things, and the negative stuff comes, he said, "Don't lose what you've got. Hang on to it. Don't let anyone steal it. Don't let go of it. You've come that far. Don't go back." And then the Lord brought a scripture to me, and I want to close with it. It's in John 10:10.
John 10:10. It says, the thief's purpose, who's the thief? Satan. The thief's purpose, and did you know that Satan comes in the form of people?
Yes.
Do you know that? Yeah. Sometimes the very people you think are going to encourage you are going to try to manipulate you.
Right.
Yeah. I think I've told the story, but if it did, forgive me, I'll do it again. Pastor Jeff told me about this. He said he had a man walk into his church in his early days, being this big building and all that stuff, and gave him a check for $10,000. You've heard me tell this. And Pastor Jeff said to the secretary treasurer there, said, put that in a separate account. Why, you know, somebody comes and gives $10,000, you know, why would you put another account, for crying out loud? Just put in the, you know, operation account of some sort. And he said, put it in a separate account. Time went along, and one day the brother walked in and began to talk to Pastor about making a change, doing something. And Pastor Jeff said, well, brother, said, the Lord hasn't revealed that to me, and so I can't do that. And he tried to speak to him about it, you know. And he said, well, Pastor Jeff, don't you remember I gave you $10,000? He said, yes, I remember that. He punched the buzzer and called his secretary. He said, that $10,000 in that separate account, write the check out to this brother and give it back to him.
Amen.
I'm going to tell you something. If you think you're going to buy your way in to the kingdom of God, you're crazy.
That's true.
It won't work that way. Now, you could buy your way through some people. Yeah. You can manipulate some. But let me tell you something. Satan comes in the form of people to steal, to kill, this is John 10:10, and destroy. But he said, my purpose is to come, give them a rich and satisfying life.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I got stuff, man, I'm so excited about the Lord, that he is doing every day, every day, every day. Every day I get up and I say, Lord, is this the day that this is going to happen? Lord, is this the day that's going to happen? Is this the day that's going to happen? You know why? Because I'm pressing on. And I'm believing by faith, the unknown that I don't know anything about, he's going to carry me there. And the thief's going to try to take it from me, but I got news for you. I got the Holy Spirit to remind me, and I can say, get lost.
Amen.
Now, I want to close. Some of you are sitting here and say, man, that sounds good. But I have felt like I was the only one. I was the only one. I felt that way. In fact, a couple of weeks ago, I had a heavy-duty attack, man, by the enemy, right in the middle of the day. And I tell you, I felt like I was the only one doing anything. And I thought, but that's not true. He said he'd never leave me nor forsake me. But I felt that. I said, how am I going to handle this? And I didn't even want to talk to Susie about it. I just wanted to be alone. I really wanted to be alone because I felt alone. But that's when I can call on the Lord.
Amen.
And he said, I've never left you. Yeah, I've never left you. Now I'm going to close by doing this. You're here today. I'm not asking you to come to the front. But I'm going to ask you to stand to your feet right where you are and say, you know, Pastor, the Holy Spirit has spoken to me and I understand for the first time what's going on and I want prayer. Stand to your feet right where you are right now. Praise God. I'm not alone. We're not alone. Lord, this job, this vision is so big, it just blows us away. But Lord, you've placed the vision there. And we're not alone. You're with us. Shane, you're not alone. Will you do that for me, please?
Hallelujah.
Lift up everyone standing here today. They're asking you, Lord, for fresh revelation, a fresh touch. Because the task before us is enormous. The finances is enormous. The completion of the projects are enormous. The reaching of the people, Lord, with a new love and a new anointing, it's enormous, Lord. And the enemy would come and try to steal from us our confidence, our faith, our assurance. I pray in Jesus' name for a new wave of your confidence and your anointing to flow in this place, Lord. And Lord, may the Holy Spirit reminding us, we are not alone. This is your work. Others have gone before us, showing us how to do it. And now we trust you through your Holy Spirit to guide our steps and give us strength so that we will not be discouraged. So when someone tries to manipulate, we'll see through it in Jesus' name. May the mighty Holy Spirit do a work in the hearts and lives of everyone standing on their feet today, as well as those, Lord, looking on in Jesus' name. This is your day. You've brought it to us to this place. And I thank you for it in Jesus' name. All week,
thank you, Lord.
May your byword be, I'm not alone.
Amen.
I'm not alone. Because the task before us, I'm telling you, is large. And it grows all the time. But we're not alone. He's going to carry us.
Amen.
Bless you. Have a great day. Don't forget the Bible study and the youth. And the Lord bless you. Have a great afternoon.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. You're not alone. Praise God. Right.